So as you guys may know, there has been a season two of The Mandalorian, and to celebrate it, Hasbro have very kindly sent out to some selected sites some press kits, and this is one I got here, so I just thought I'd give you some quick snaps of some of the stuff. There is a lot in this box to review. I've just started reviewing The Mandalorian, I'll get round to all the others as soon as I can, but I thought I'll show you some of this stuff. Now look, not everybody can get these, I understand, some people are really unhappy about it. This is the way it's been. It's not me who decides who gets this stuff, but certainly there's been a few things we've donated in the past, and some of this will be donated yet again. But we'll take you through and give you a look at what is included in this press box that they sent out, but it's quite a pile of stuff. So as you can see, it's going to take me a little while to get through this. But Monopoly, which is really impressive. We'll go through and show you that in a minute. A couple of Black Series figures already reviewed the main Mandalorian one figure there, but the armor is included too. Got a couple of other mission fleet figure, some vintage collection figures, and I pre-ordered quite a few of these. Some of them I couldn't actually get yet, so that's actually really nice. I'll be able to give you a review of them, and even a few of these other figures as well, where I was proving a little bit hard to get the what was called the Berry figure, the Target exclusive and the Best Buy exclusive, but I'll now be able to give you a review on them soon too. So Darksaber, I'd already covered. I'd ended up buying one a couple of months back and donating it to one of the kids in my building here, a little autistic boy who is insanely mad about the Mandalorian and has just been going nuts with this thing. His brother didn't get one, but he's now going to get a second one. So I've already kind of covered in a little video before the Mandalorian Darksaber, but it is pretty cool. The blue glow off it, the sounds, check it out. And it's a really inexpensive toy. So if you haven't seen it already, and it's Sabine's too, I guess, of course, Sabine and the Mandalorian Darksaber. But a really cool little quick video just shows you the sounds, which I did maybe about a month ago. So a lot of figures here, just diving through. We've got the Imperial Death Trooper, which we're going to give a review. But I mean, really, this figure is an older figure. It is now just been repainted, but some kind of nice effects. He's one of the nicer ones, I think, out of all of the credit collection. I do like the gold and purple, and it is quite close to what we see in the final sequence, or the end credits, I should say, or the artwork. So he is one of my favorites, actually. I do like him. So we'll go through and get into more on him soon enough. There's Bounty Collection figures in there, quite a few of them, and isn't that one of the cutest little baby Yodas? Those eyes, oh my goodness. So already Mrs. Fly and another friend of mine, they'll be pinching them. So I won't even get a chance to get a look at them. They're already been stolen. This though, has to be said, this is pretty damn cool. Now this one unfortunately wasn't the Retro Collection version. So there's two versions. One comes with a Retro Collection figure with the Remnant Stormtrooper, aka the 1970s vintage Stormtrooper with a little bit of dirt on him. So it's not too dramatically different, but this one is different. But the packaging is out of this world. Really nicely done. Just looks incredible. But it's these game pieces as well, which are really pretty hefty and very different. Comes with two different stacks of the Mandalorian cards, and the board is all themed. As you'd imagine, you get out of jail and so forth and so on. All the stuff that you would imagine a Monopoly set to have. But the game plays quite differently, and I'll show you that in just a minute. And there's some of the instructions that are in there. I'll let you freeze frame and have a read around it. But it's slightly different Monopoly. It doesn't read to be exactly the same as other games. These weighted pieces are very nice, very die-cast, heavy, solid pieces for some of them. Let me show you another pick. Oh, there's the Bounty Collection figures. So some of these I've already reviewed on the channel, but there's more there, just so you can see them. But I mean, you've probably seen these in stores, but they're uber cute. The one with the Stormtrooper helmet's been really hard to find. The one with the Mandalorian symbol as well, they're just pretty much out. But this little guy here in his crib has been very, very popular around my house. But there you go, Darksaber and the Mission Fleet, which are pretty cool too. And you're finding them these at most stores around the globe. Seeing people finding these easily at Walmarts, Big W's, all sorts of stores around the globe. So there's plenty of them heading around, and the Darksaber. But these guys, these were a little bit tough to get. So again, just popped up a review of this. I've only had time to do a review of the Mandalorian, but we'll get to these other guys soon enough. All are repaints, but so there's nothing new. Don't expect any new articulation or anything. But as I've said in this credit collection Mandalorian review, it's pretty spot on with the paint. There's definitely a few discrepancies and differences. The green shoulder pad comes to mind, and the colors are a little different, but ultimately, it's not too bad. I do like it. I do like the colors, particularly the heavy is pretty cool. He's probably my favorite overall, with Karen being my probably least favorite, but she is probably the most color representative if you really want to look at it that way. Not finding these credit collection chips of a great deal of use, but they're kind of cool. They might come in handy for cosplay, etc. But there you go. But a very nice set of cards. He's a whopping size of card, this heavy Mandalorian. Absolutely mammoth size. So he's blown out my nice kind of 40th anniversary style slots for this guy here. So IG-11 is not included here. And I've still not bought that one yet. But yeah, I can't bring myself to buy that one. But these guys look pretty good. I think the card art in these four guys is definitely the strongest of my mind. But yeah, let us know what you think. But yeah, all the same figures, nothing different about them, but just differences in paint. And you'll have to get a look at the Mandalorian review, which is going up just at the same time as this. And I'll get ready to do the other ones as soon as I can. Same for these guys. Same figures that we've had before. Cara Dune, Death Trooper, Remnant Stormtrooper, the Mandalorian. Incinerator Trooper is brand new, and so is Din Djarin. So I just ordered these, so I'll wait until my other ones arrive, and I can, hopefully if they arrive in good nick, I can give you a review of these ones too, because gotta have one to rock, one in stock, man. But yes, these were exclusive, so it's really nice to get a bit of a hand to try and get some of these. Heavily reflective cards, these are very, very shiny. I didn't expect the cards to be quite as shiny. And the sticker is there, the carbonized graphite sticker, which I don't think they really needed. But not a fan of these stickers, man, if you know what I'm like with the retro stickers. But some of these work. The Mandalorian does work, definitely. So does the Death Trooper, and so does Cara Dune. There's something about her armor just looks really nice, and it really kind of pops through. But the Remnant Stormtrooper for me is probably the weakest of the bunch. It's got a kind of weird pearl essence off him. And anyway, as soon as I get the other one to open, I'll give you a review of that. But, you know, same figures, shiny. That's it. But, you know, if you want to collect these, then there you go. But very reflective cards, very, very shiny. And they'll look very nice if you've got a lit cabinet and what you want to put in there. But these guys too, very nice indeed, getting these figures in this new style with all the little bit of credit collection chips and the ice cream maker and so forth. But yeah, they look very, very cool. So looking forward to getting another ones hopefully soon. And we'll dig in with the reviews. What else have we got? These chess pieces. I mean, not chess pieces, Monopoly pieces. Get a load of these. These are pretty damn cool. So we've got the Mandalorian, the Child, Cara Dune. I can't remember his name, Quill, IG-11. We've got, it is a Stormtrooper, but he's red. Doesn't make sense, really, because that would be a kind of Sith Trooper. The Death Trooper, and what's his face, Breaking Bad? Moff Gideon. There we go. But they're really pretty heavy. There's something quite nice about them, even as a kind of display piece. They look pretty cool. The paint is kind of lost a little bit on the colored ones, but the silver really has a nice kind of finish on them that just pops out some of the style and the designs. But yeah, they're pretty cool. You get a look at some of these cards as well in the sets. They've all got little shots from the show too. So a very different Monopoly set if you're thinking of getting it. There you go, just to give you a bit of a scale on size. But they're really nice. They're definitely not like other Monopoly pieces. So highly recommend the set, especially if you can find the one with the retro collection. Seems to be exclusive to some stores. I certainly know in Australia it's Zing. It might be different. Was it Walmart in the US? I can't remember off the top of my head. I'll try and find it and put it in the show notes with all the details. But yes, it's pretty cool. Very cool looking set for Monopoly indeed. Don't discount this one. It's if you're into The Mandalorian, you will probably adore the Monopoly set. And that's something I don't see very often. I generally don't really like Monopoly sets too much. This is probably the set to buy. This is the way. This figure's looking pretty damn cool though. And again, just trying to get another one there so I can rip this guy open and we'll give you a review. But you can pretty much see it's near enough the same figure. It looks to my initial thoughts, but obviously with the slightly different tweaks on the shoulder and so forth. Nice ice cream maker, and it will take these little chips inside them. It does expand out, which is really cool. And Baby Yoda, or the Child, just wow. Just looks fantastic. They just absolutely nailed the eyes there, and the weathering as well looks really, really good. And a nice sticker. We've got a logo on this one. Looks really good. So, and of course, the couldn't resist and say includes the Mandalorian, the Child, which is the biggest selling factor, I think, of this pack. But yes, great looking figure. Does look really good and very, very cool on the artwork again for him. There's just a little shot on the back of it, just shows you a bit more about the set and just all the different cards and the layout, etc. And all the little credit chips you're going to play with, which kind of look exactly like the ones from the credit collection. So yes, very cool game this indeed. I'm looking forward to hopefully over the holiday season to get time to play this, but it does look good. And there we go, just another little shot of the Heavy. Probably one of my favourite figures of the year, but just love the artwork on that. Just absolutely banging. Really, really good. All that kind of stained glass-like look. Looks very nice indeed. And again, he's kind of got the right colour of cheeks. If you've seen my Mandalorian review, where Mando didn't quite have the right colour on his cheeks, this guy does. So the colours look pretty good on this one. I'm quite impressed. Probably next to Cara, the best ones out of the pack, but he's awesome. I love him. Just a great, great figure. And that was it. So again, some of this has been donated. Sorry, I'd love to share it with everybody. We might do some giveaways in the 6-inch show hopefully soon. I've mentioned it and I've still not done it, but we'll get there. So yes, let us know what you think. If you're into any of these, hopefully this gave you a little bit of an insight, especially into Monopoly, which again, highly recommend. And this guy too, particularly good figures. And we've already talked in the 6-inch show about some of these figures, not these ones, sorry, the 6-inch show is a credit collection and mixed thoughts on them, but certainly these are the four strongest ones out the pack. But it is a shame it's an exclusive, that they are so hard to get. It took me and has cost me a lot of money to try and get the other ones, but well, at least now I'm a little spoiled. I can get to open these and give you some reviews as I've just done for the Mandalorian. So there you go. That's it. We'll see you soon. And again, thanks to Hasbro. And yeah, more reviews coming right up.